Greetings from Utah. Today I'm in Moab, and this is Red Rock Canyon country. The Moab area is famous for so many things, but the top on the list is number one, the Colorado River that has carved out this beautiful canyon, two epic national parks, you have arches and Canyonlands, and three beautiful scenic byways. Moab has the most spectacular red rock landscape and formation, some of the most unique in all the world. And that's why that many movie magnates have wanted to come to this area to film their movies. For decades, there have been Western movies made here, lots of other movies, even Indiana Jones. It's a photographer's paradise. And honestly, I think I might have a callus on my finger from taking so many pictures. And they also have something called dark sky parks. That's because their public lands here are some of the darkest in all of America. And then interestingly, this place is known worldwide, especially with Europeans who love to come here on vacation. We actually discovered Moab about 20 years ago. We came with a group and did this epic jeeping adventure trip with our girls years ago, and it's one of those trips that we still talk about. It was so much fun. Well, on this trip, we did the whitewater rafting trip here on the Colorado with the Mile to Wild adventure tour, and it was so much fun, and you can do it at any level, just depending on how much of an adrenaline rush you want to have. And it's a great way also to keep cool during the summer. So Moab has changed a lot, but not. Of course, the landscape hasn't changed at all because it's millions and millions of years old. But the town itself has. When we were here 20 years ago, it was just like a little village, almost like a little community. But now it's the cutest, most quaint little town. It has lots of nice shops and so many brand new hotels and lots of outfitters and touring companies, and then many dining options. We were excited to see that our favorite restaurant is still here. Well, in fact, it's the oldest restaurant in Moab since 1954. It's called Sunset Grill, and it sits way up on top of a mountain and just has great food and spectacular views, especially at sunset. But the coolest thing of all about it is that it's the former home of Charlie Steen, and he was known as the Uranium King because he discovered uranium in these hills and became one of the wealthiest men in all of the Southwest. So when you think of Moab, think of M-O-A-B, M for magnificent and marvelous, O for outdoor opportunities, A for adventure abounds, and B for breathtakingly beautiful. Just another travel tidbit from Travel with Terri.